ओके स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ईच एंड एवरी आंसर्स ओके ऑफ द टेस्ट. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग आर एक्सोथर्मिक प्रोसेस. सो एक्सोथर्मिक प्रोसेस स्टूडेंट्स, यू नो इन विच हीट इज इवॉल्व्ड. सो द रिएक्शन ऑफ वाटर विथ क्विक लाइम, येस इट इज एन एक्सोथर्मिक प्रोसेस. अमाउंट ऑफ हीट इज रिलीज ड्यूरिंग दिस रिएक्शन. नंबर टू, नंबर सेकेंड ऑप्शन, डायल्यूशन ऑफ एन एसिड. Dilution of an acid means when you are mixing water to an acid, definitely heat will release. So it is also an exothermic reaction. Evaporation of water is not an exothermic reaction. And sublimation of camphor is also not an exothermic reaction. Because in both of these, heat is not evolved. So the right answer is option number A. Option A. That is that involves 1 and 2, that is reaction of water with quicklime and dilution of an acid. Okay, so the next question, which of the following statements about a given reactions are correct? So this was the reaction, 3Fe plus 4H2O gives Fe3O4 plus 4H2O. Students, all of you look carefully. Here the iron metal is get oxidized and it will form, see, Fe3O4, and this water molecule H2O is getting reduced to H2. So I told you, I explained you, the substance which get reduced act as a oxidizing agent. So here in this statement, this is also correct, that iron metal is getting oxidized. This statement is also correct, water is getting reduced, and the last statement is correct, water is acting as oxidizing agent. So the correct option is C, that involves 1, 2 and 4. Okay. Next question was, electrolysis of water is a decomposition reaction. The mole ratio of hydrogen and oxygen gases liberated during electrolysis of water is. So during electrolysis of water, I told you, the water molecules consists of the, in this electrolysis I explained you, water molecules consist of two atoms of hydrogen and one molecules of oxygen. So the ratio will be 2:1. Next question is, which of the following is a physical change? You know students, what is a physical change? Which can be reversed, which are reversible changes. So the first option was formation of curd from milk. It is irreversible change, no? Second option is ripening of fruits. That is also irreversible change. Next, getting salt from seawater. Yeah, that's a reversible change. So that is a physical change. So that is the correct option. That is option C, getting salt from seawater. Next is burning of wood. That is also irreversible change. So that was also not a physical change. So in question number 5, option C is the correct answer. That is getting salt from seawater. Okay, so the next question is, what is the following is not a combination reaction? You know students, in combination reaction, two reactants combine and form one product. So in this first option, the reaction of hydrogen with nitrogen, it combines and form ammonia. So it's a combination reaction. Next is reaction of quicklime with water. It also forms quicklime with water. Again, two reactants are there forming a single product, that is calcium hydroxide. It is also a combination reaction. Third option, combustion of magnesium in air. Again, magnesium reacts with oxygen, forms magnesium oxide. It is also an example of combination reaction. Last option is heating of limestone, CaCO3, that is calcium carbonate or limestone. When we heat it, it decomposes to form calcium oxide and CO2, that is carbon dioxide. So this is the decomposition reaction. This is the example of decomposition reaction. So among these four options, these three are the examples of combination reaction. But the question was asked, which is not a combination reaction? So this is not a combination reaction because this is a decomposition reaction. So here the optional question get finished. Now we will start up with the short answer type question.